As an Android user, the more I learn about this iPhone 17 Pro, the more I like it. Rumor is that this orange iPhone 17 Pro has a new vapor chamber inside, and it's surprisingly repairable. With an asterisk, of course. My new toolkit collab with iFixit has 32 high-precision bits inside, and knowing Apple, I'll probably have to use all of them. The most commonly repaired components, like the screen and the battery, are going to be accessible from the front. But since the back panel is made from glass, and as we know, glass is glass, let's pop that off first to see how hard it'll be to fix. One thing I didn't immediately realize or recognize is that Apple has found a rather ingenious way to tie both the back glass and the front glass into the same set of pentalobe screws at the bottom of the phone. So as I'm heating up that back glass and carefully separating it from the aluminum frame with my suction cup and ultra-thin pry tool, taking out those bottom two screws first would have made my life a whole lot easier. Learning from other people's mistakes, though, is quicker than making them all yourself, so I'm just helping future you out with your own repairs. With the back glass off, there's a thin ribbon cable in the upper left corner that connects the 25-watt wireless charger to the motherboard. We don't know the official cost of these replacement pieces just yet, but since magnets lose about 1% of their strength every 10 years or so, pretty much all of these will need to be replaced by the year 3000. Just something to budget for. Taking out the two pentalobe screws is easy, something I should have done first thing. Another, you know, minorly catastrophic issue I had was that instead of lifting up as hard as I should have with the suction cup, I inserted my thin pry tool far too early and killed the screen. It looks like I won't be joining the blue bubble gang after all. I'll show you the damage here in a second, but I should have lifted up on the screen until a gap was clearly visible, and then gently worked my way around the edges after that to slice away the adhesive. I'm obviously making these mistakes on purpose so as to demonstrate what not to do. This phone has given up the ghost so that others may live, and there are plenty of nifty little noteworthy nuggets that we can still find on the inside. Luckily, if someone is removing the screen, there's a very good chance that it's already broken in the first place, so you won't have to worry as much about it surviving. Apple, in their wisdom to make repairs easier and more foolproof, have copied a page out of the Pixels textbook and included a barrier between where the screen sits and the rest of the phone, protecting the battery. It's way harder to break something when it's protected by metal. I mean, look at Iron Man. You can see where I sliced into the screen on the lower portion when I inserted my tool in too early. The screen has two ribbons on the left side, with a Phillips head screw holding down the Lego-style ribbon connector. This iPhone 17 Pro screen could be replaced by an experienced technician in about 2 minutes. Apple does now sell replacement parts directly to customers, which is pretty cool of them, thumbs up for that. The front-facing camera and face unlock hardware is still inside the phone. Something I've always wished these cameras could do, though, is take a picture of anyone who's attempted to unlock my phone without my permission. You know, for an extra layer of security. Luckily, my favorite security app and the sponsor of today's video, Bitdefender, is able to do exactly that, and you can try it free for 90 days. I'll remove the 17 screws around the metal sheet that protects the iPhone hardware. Aside from protecting your device in the physical world, Bitdefender also protects you and your family in the digital realm. Bitdefender Premium Security comes with an unlimited VPN, password manager, real-time email protection, and my favorite feature, Scam Copilot. With a lot of regular humans thinking AI-generated videos and deepfakes are real, these scammers are getting crazy sophisticated. And the best way to bust AI-powered scams is with an AI-powered defense against online fraud. Scam Copilot is a clanker fighting with the good guys. You can ask the Scam Copilot chatbot questions or send it screenshots to see if a text or email is a scam, and he can protect 5 of your devices at the same time. You don't gotta take my word for it though, Bitdefender is a global leader in cybersecurity, and millions of people around the world trust Bitdefender with their data, and thanks to the link in the description, you can try it free for 90 days. With the 17 T5 Torx screws gone, and the Phillips head screw holding the bracket on top of the battery plug removed, we can lift off the shield between the screen and the phone's internal hardware, where the battery, wait, the battery is missing. Oh, there it is, it's attached to the midframe. I'm shocked at how reasonable Apple is being with this whole repairability thing. If Apple sells this battery already attached to the tray, this is actually a pretty chill repair. Assuming, of course, you can get the screen off in one piece.
I believe in you.
This is the same style of metal enclosed battery we saw last year, with the electrically debonding adhesive strip under the metal case. The metal case around the battery adds an extra layer of protection against puncturing. which, as we saw on the Pixel 10 Pro Fold, can be a pretty smoky experience. The midframe also has the first ever Apple Vapor Chamber attached to it. This vapor chamber sits on top of the new A19 processor and keeps it cool, so you can scroll through fire memes more efficiently. If the chip overheats, it will throttle performance. Peeling back the graphite layer reveals that we still can't access the vapor chamber without pulling off the battery first. The vapor chamber appears to be very much a permanent part of that midframe, though. Android users have been familiar with these things for the past 9 years. Samsung's had one in their phone since the Galaxy S7 back in 2016. But for the Apple users just joining the party, the way a vapor chamber works is that a small drop of water gets inserted inside the chamber and sealed up at the factory. You can see the little droplets of liquid still inside the chamber. Then, as the processor heats up that drop of liquid, it evaporates, taking a lot of the heat energy at the hot end of the vapor chamber, traveling to the other side, condensing back into liquid, dispersing its heat, and gets ready to repeat the process, very similar to how an air conditioner uses phase change to cool down your house. The metal mesh inside helps wick that liquid back to the hot end so it can happen over and over. Between the charging coil, metal battery, and new age vapor chamber, the iPhone 17 Pro is turning out to be even cooler on the inside than it is on the outside. Switching over to our fourth screwdriver bit, a flathead, to remove the standoff screw, these are basically a screw for holding a screw within a screw, screwception, where one screw screws into another screw for holding multiple layers of components. With the standoff screws removed, we can pop out the Taptic Engine vibrator. I do have a full vibrator review coming out soon, so keep an eye out for that one. I did some counting after this teardown was all over, and there are more than 70 different size screws in this iPhone 17 Pro. So forgive me if I don't mark the location of all of them this time around. If you ever happen to find yourself this deep in an iPhone 17 Pro, you need way more help than I can give, or an exorcist. The front-facing camera has the new square sensor inside. We ripped one of these open in the iPhone Air teardown, so if you want to see the sensor, you can check out that video. The rear-facing cameras are all 48 megapixels and tied together in one large housing. Neither the ultra-wide, the telephoto, nor the main camera have exterior optical image stabilization, but the main camera and telephoto both have sensor shift stabilization on the inside, which is just as, if not more, capable than regular OIS. Sensor shift is still a physical form of stabilization. The upper loudspeaker does look pretty normal. Remember, the iPhone Air does not have stereo speakers, while the iPhone 17 Pro does. It does not, however, have any windows where we could see the balls inside, which means we have to bust them open instead. And indeed, we do find balls inside. These give the speaker's sound waves something to bounce off of inside the box, so the tiny speaker doesn't sound like a tin can. Balls make little speakers sound bigger and more full than they actually are. After a bunch more screws are removed, I can pull away the motherboard with its new A19 chip in it. It's always shocking how tiny these things are. The whole board is about the size of a quarter, or whatever coin this is. Sorry if I forget your name, I'm from the USA, and we only care about Argentina for some reason. Finally, the last thing to come out of the phone is the charging port. And for some reason, Apple has more screws holding in this singular port than Samsung uses in their whole phone. I do not understand it. The lower loudspeaker also has balls inside, which is nifty. And there you go. The whole iPhone torn down with its aluminum body and antenna line around the camera plateau. I think this is by far the coolest and most capable iPhone Apple has ever made. All of the main repairs are simple enough, like the screen, the back glass, and the battery. And if I was gonna switch, this would be the one I would buy. If. I'm not gonna switch, but if I was. I'm just thinking about it. Grab one of my toolkits for your future self down in the description, and don't forget your free 90 days worth of Bitdefender, so you can keep yourself secure both at home and abroad. Thanks a ton for watching. I'll see you around.